Hey everyone, it's Jordan from Fish Keeping Made Easy, and today I'm going to talk about a couple of corals I recently got from a nano reef tank. So recently I've added a couple more corals to my tank. Now, like I said, some people probably would consider these among some of the worst possible corals you can get for your tank for many different reasons, but I thought they were both kind of cool and they weren't really that expensive, so I bought them anyway. So the first coral is Alveopora. Now, this coral is very similar to Goniopora and was actually the name I was originally sold it under. So after a little bit of research, I discovered the best way to tell the difference between Goniopora and Aviopora is that Aviopora has 12 tentacles at the end of their polyps and Goniopora has 24, so mine only had 12, so therefore it was Alveopora, but I can see how people get these corals mixed up because they almost look identical. These corals are also known as flowerpot corals or golf ball corals, and from the footage here it's quite obvious to see where they get their name from. Now, I actually wanted to get a hammer or a frog spawn or a torch, but due to things with imports happening and prices skyrocketing, there didn't seem to be that much choice in the local fish shop. Most of the corals were either far too expensive or they were just too big for my tank. But just like with a hammer or a frog spawn or a torch, this is an LPS coral that gives off that appearance of a soft coral, so I thought that this more or less fitted the bill. So why would this coral be considered a bad coral? Well, the thing is, it doesn't have the greatest lifespan. Most people say it only lasts between 6 to 18 months. So after a little bit of research, I found the best way to extend this coral's lifespan is through feeding. So what I've been doing right now is feeding them little bits of red plankton, phytoplankton, fish eggs, lobster eggs, just any little foods that I tend to feed to my clownfish. The only issue is that the polyps seem to be super sensitive, so whenever anything touches them, even little bits of debris, they tend to retract a little bit. People have said that they do better in systems that don't have skimmers in them. This way there's more free flowing particles about in the water, which gets them a lot more acclimated to things touching their polyps. And is also an easy, non-intrusive way to basically feed them. So far, this coral has been pretty good, but as you can see from the footage, it kinda closed up a little bit due to a water change, but it's slowly coming round. So I won't give my opinion on this coral just yet. I'll give it, you know, 6 months or a year, and then I'll actually tell you if I think it's a decent coral or not. Hopefully it can live beyond its, you know, suspected lifespan, because it is quite a cool coral and I do really like it. So the next coral that I got was Pulsing Zinnia. Now, this is probably one of those corals that divides the community. It's one of those corals that can basically just take over a tank, so people who have been in the hobby for a long time consider this to almost be a weed or a pest. But for beginners like myself, it can be one of those corals that's really easy to grow and it can really fill your tank out and it can really just give you a lot of confidence when you're keeping corals. Not to mention its really cool pulsing movements as well. The movements it makes is basically what drew me in, so a lot of people ask, like, why does it pulse and how does it pulse? So it seems people aren't really sure why it pulses, but I think the common consensus is that basically it pulses to push water around the polyps, so just to add a little bit more of flow. So what you kind of find is if your tank does have quite a decent flow, then the Pulsing Zinnia doesn't seem to pulse as much. There are a few different varieties of Pulsing Zinnia and that can really affect how much it pulses. People also say that pH can affect how it pulses, but so far mine seems to be doing pretty well. However, saying all that, talking about how it's a weed and it can grow, some people actually really struggle to keep it alive, and again, it's kind of unknown why it does really, really well in some tanks and it just completely dies off in others. Again, I think this coral is really, really cool, but I'm not going to give my opinion on it again, just in case it does happen to take over my tank and sort of destroy it, but for the now, I really like it and I think it's awesome. So both of these corals do have a bit of a reputation, but what I really wanted to say at the end of this video was it's important to get corals that you want and that you like. At the end of the day, it's your tank, so you can kind of put whatever corals or whatever fish you want in. Yes, you kind of want to take advice from people, but you don't have to then not get things just because other people don't like them. Basically, people have different experiences with different corals, so you need to kind of take people's opinions with a grain of salt. So really what I want to say is, if you want something, just get it. Don't let other people dictate what goes into your tank. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more, and I will see you in the next one.